Students, let's continue the study of biomolecules by another micromolecule, that is amino acids. And you know that amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. Now these amino acids are the organic compounds containing an amino group and an acidic group as substituent on the same carbon, that is alpha carbon. Hence they are called alpha amino acids. And alpha carbon also bears a hydrogen and a variable group. So what is the general structure of amino acid? The general structure is R, which is a variable component, and there is a carboxyl group, and there is NH2 amino group, and there is hydrogen. So this is the amino acid general structure. The amino group accepts a proton, whereas the carboxyl group donates a proton. So amino acid can act as both acid as well as base. And it is called amphoteric in nature. So amino acids are amphoteric in nature. The R group is variable. This can be hydrogen, can be methyl, can be hydroxyl, methyl. So the chemical and physical properties of amino acids are essentially due to the amino, carboxyl and R functional groups present. Now based on the number of amino acids and carboxyl group, this can be your acidic amino acid. Now, acidic amino acids, the amino group and two carboxyl groups per molecule. And basic amino acids, when two amino groups and one carboxyl group is present. And when neutral amino acids, when they contain one amino group and one carboxyl group is present, that is neutral amino acids. And aromatic amino acids, which are aromatic rings in the side chain, that is phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan, like that. Now, so how these two amino acids, how they joined? So if this is one amino acid that I have drawn, if you draw two amino acids, now this is the NH2 group, this is the COH group, this is R group and this is H group. Now if this is joined, so here this NH2 is joined, you see COH, this is R and this is H. Now this is the peptide bond formation occur, and that is by elimination of one H2O. Peptide bond formation occur, and that peptide bond is nothing but that. This is a peptide bond. The peptide bond joins two amino acids. Now there are 20 types of amino acids which are found in human being, and names are like alanine, serine, glycine. That all the 20 types of amino acids are because of this R is variable. It may be H, it may be CH3, it may be CH2, like that. Next one that we are going to discuss is primary and secondary metabolites. Now primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Now primary metabolites are what? These are found in animal tissues. The functions are easily identifiable. Specific roles in physiological process like amino acid, carbohydrate, proteins, nitrogenase base, nucleic acid. And secondary metabolites are what? These are generally found in plant, that is fungi, microbial cells as a byproduct of metabolic reactions. And these are identifiable in host organism, alkaloids, flavonoids, rubber, essential oils, antibiotics, colored pigments, scents, gum, spices, all these are secondary metabolites. Now both primary and secondary metabolites serve many functions. They have very ecological importance. Now next we will go to study the proteins. So what is this primary metabolite and secondary metabolite is clear. Now next is protein. Now proteins that are made up of amino acids, building blocks. Now amino acids are joined by peptide bond that you have seen, and each protein is a polymer of amino acids. 20 types of amino acids are there, like alanine, valine, arginine, leucine, histidine. Now there are certain amino acids which are essential amino acids as well as non-essential amino acids are also present. Essential and non-essential amino acids are present. The essential amino acids are what? Which are essential for our health and need to be supplied through our diet. Non-essential amino acids are what? These are amino acids which the body can synthesize. Now, structure of proteins, that may be of primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure. So, these four different types of structures are formed. Now, primary structure is the basic structure of a protein, which includes number and sequence of amino acids in each polypeptide. Protein, that is N-terminal amino acids and C-terminal amino acids, they are the two ends. Secondary structure, the primary structure is just a long chain, okay, linear. Secondary structure is somehow looped. So this type of structure is a long one. It is the N-terminal and C-terminal protein is there. And this structure is called secondary structure circuit. And tertiary structures are, yeah, variety of structures. And quaternary structure is the one polypeptide chain and another polypeptide chain. They are bound to each other. So, secondary structure is a loop like, or it is called a helix or alpha, that is pleated, beta pleated secondary structure can be possible. So, alpha helix, this is alpha helix and beta pleated structure can be possible. So, this is alpha helix, N and C terminal. Now, this tertiary structure is folded. This folding is possible because of variety of bonds like hydrogen bond, ionic bond, van der Waals interactions, covalent bond and hydrophobic bonds. Quaternary structure is more complex, which are made up of two polypeptide subunits, and like hemoglobin, lactic acid dehydrogenase enzymes. So these are quaternary structure where two polypeptides are joined. Now types of proteins, this can be a fibrous protein, globular protein. So various proteins are there in our body which perform our different kinds of functions, like collagen is there, trypsin is there, then insulin is there. So different types of protein structures are there. Antibody is there. So collagen is what? Intracellular ground substance. Trypsin is enzyme. Insulin is hormone. Antibody fight against germs, that is antigen. And there are certain receptors also. So proteins are variety of functions in our body that helps in transportation of nutrients, helps in fighting with an infectious agent, helps pull in movement of muscle like actin and myosin. That are also protein found in muscle, myosin and actin. So helps in maintenance of pH, helps at the time of injury and the blood clotting, helps in growth and repair. So proteins also act as enzyme like trypsin and hormones such as insulin also. Now when proteins are exposed to extreme change in pH, acids and temperature, that is high salt concentration, the denaturation of protein happens. Denaturation is not strong enough to break peptide bond, thus primary structure remains unaffected. So denatured protein may spontaneously refold into its original structure with suitable conditions given. That is called renaturation. So proteins can be denatured and it can be also renatured. So this is all about proteins and its structures. Go through NCERT. Thank you.